You may have seen this picture in the news recently. This is a Samsung Galaxy Note 7 phone that caught on fire. Or if you think back to around the holidays last year, you may remember seeing this picture. This is a hoverboard that caught on fire. What do these two pictures have in common? Both devices use lithium-ion batteries, and the fires were the result of these batteries. So the question naturally arises, why do we continue to use a battery that can fail so dangerously? The answer is that out of all the commercially available batteries, lithium-ion batteries have one of the highest energy densities. What is meant by a high energy density is that only a small volume of electrode is required to produce a large amount of energy. This characteristic makes lithium-ion batteries particularly ideal for applications such as laptops, cell phones, and electric cars, where space is limited. This high energy density also makes lithium-ion batteries good candidates for use in storing wind and solar energy. You may be wondering why a chemist like me is working on what is typically considered an engineering problem. The answer is that the charging and discharging of lithium-ion batteries occurs on a molecular level. This means that chemists have a unique perspective to offer to the study of lithium-ion batteries. In fact, during the charging and discharging, the nanoparticles, which make up the electrode, can undergo a volume expansion and contraction of up to 300%. This expansion and contraction occurs every time the battery is charged and then used. Over time, this change in volume can lead to the formation of cracks in the electrode, the overall deformation of the electrode, and in extreme cases, fires. You have experienced electrode deformation in your daily life. When you purchase a new laptop or a new cell phone, you can go for hours without charging it. However, the longer that you own it and the more that you use it, you will find yourself having to charge it more and more frequently. This is capacitance loss, and this is a symptom of electrode deformation. The reason why catastrophic battery failure and electrode deformation are still problems that have not yet been solved is because of the current techniques used to study lithium-ion batteries. Most of these techniques require that you remove the electrode from the battery in order to perform a measurement. However, once you remove that electrode, the battery is destroyed. It cannot be reassembled and it cannot be cycled further. This means that these measurements are at best a snapshot of the battery's health at that particular moment in time. You cannot see how it was previously or how it would be if it were cycled further. As you can imagine, this severely limits our knowledge of what is going on inside a battery as it is cycling. I am fortunate to collaborate with the Sheldon Engineering Lab here at Brown, and they provide me with lithium-ion batteries, which allows me to focus on developing a new technique to study them. I use X-ray scatter imaging to image the electrode's evolution as the battery is cycling. The X-rays can penetrate through the entire battery casing, which means that the electrode does not have to be removed. X-ray scatter imaging is sensitive to changes in volume as well as the formation of cracks. With this technique, I can capture a movie of how the electrode is evolving as the battery is cycling. With the data I collect, we can have a better understanding of what is going on inside these batteries and use this information to develop solutions to the problems of catastrophic battery failure and electrode deformation. This technique can also be implemented into factories to screen batteries as they are being produced. This way, defective batteries will not leave the factories and enter into consumer products. My research matters because the safety and durability of batteries is holding us back technologically. With the safety and durability improved, batteries can reach their full potential of being used in cell phones, laptops, electric cars, alternative energy power plants, and even in applications that we have not imagined yet. My hope is that in the near future, the news headlines will not be about not be about lithium-ion batteries catching on fire, but rather about the construction of new solar power plants and wind power plants that are successfully using lithium-ion batteries to store the energy that they produce. Thank you.